coming, Georgia, because we're a small town. It's got the small town feel. The employees that we're able to attract, they are hard workers. They're working because they need money. They're working because they want to work. And that really makes it easy to work with them and develop their leadership skills and invest in them and spend time with them because they've been here so long. And through all the thick and thin that we've been through, their training has led them to be leaders here in the organization. So Carson's one of the five team leaders that we talked about earlier, and she's been with us over 8 years. We started with Carson as a sophomore in high school, and she has truly developed into one of our team leaders here. And she's also one of those that leads from the front. You never see Carson sit down. You never see her stand around and talk. She's always in the dining room talking with customers, a very guest-centric approach to how she leads this team and has for years now.
This restaurant means everything to Bruce. He loves it so much, and the fact that he would leave it to do marketing, events, catering, even go on vacation, literally means everything to me, the fact that he would leave me in charge.
Bruce is always friendly, and he's always very accommodating, and he makes sure that you have everything you need, and he always comes by and checks. If you need more to drink, he's right there. He's a great guy, just all around great guy.
Victoria is another one of our team leaders, and she's the perfect example of someone starting with you in high school and just watching you develop and grow into a true leader that you can trust turning the keys over to the restaurant while I go out into the community. She has been a wonderful example of what can happen when you start with an employee early and instill those leadership skills.
I've been working here for 2 years. And Bruce has taught me in this restaurant that to care for the people that come in, like family, he's always really nice to them, always gives them the best of the best here.
Thank you for coming. So when you want something for me?
Well, I've always been a big fan of John Maxwell and his writings. How successful people lead book is a real short book, and it's real concise, taking you through the five different levels of leadership, starting from your initial position. As I've been hired as the manager, that's my position, so people respect me because I'm their manager, and it guides you up the ladder to earning the employees' respect by the way that you lead and by what you do, earning their trust. And so it's a great little read on developing your leaders in your organization to take them from the initial level all the way up to being a true leader. Jack, you chip off the old block. You've been here, well, pretty much since day one. He's he must know.
I've really evolved over the years through his training. You know, he's really done a good job of developing me and our employees. So it's been cool to see that over the years, and it certainly helped me working here.
I'm constantly impressed and also envious of Bruce's position of not only his desire for personal development and to adopt new things and to learn new procedures, but also the ability for him to transfer that through training to his team and build a strong core group of leaders.
Every franchisee in the Lenny system has invested a tremendous amount of time, money, and blood, sweat, and tears trying to be successful. And being nominated as a potential franchisee of the year is the pinnacle of proof that what you're doing, what we're doing here, means something and we're headed in the right direction. I appreciate the accolades, but really the credit goes to our team over here, and that's what really drives this restaurant.